Hi guys, just gonna have a go at this little electronic kit I picked up on eBay. It's listed as a high voltage igniter, I think it said. It's not got very many components, so shouldn't take too long to put together. I'm sure I had a good reason for buying it, but I can't think why. So, circuit board, HV at that end, a QD, Q1 is D880, which is that fella, yeah, so that's going to go there. Have to bend the legs. One resistor, 33 ohms. Be that one. One diode, 5819. That's a 4007. Well, that's what they've supplied, so that's what we're going to use. Push switch. And this thing that's looks like a coil sealed in resin. Okay. It's got three copper wires coming out of it. Well, there's four actually. Two of them are common together and two separate. And then there's these two bits of wire that come out. They're insulated and they're the ones that will make the spark or arc or whatever at the end. So that one obviously fits there. Camera's not going to pick this up. I can see on the print here, there's a thick white line going to that hole, a thick white line and a thin white line going to that hole, and a thin white line going to that hole. So that corresponds to thick wire, thick and thin together, and thin wire. They're all pre-tinned, so they just go into there. Push switch, capacitor. Electrolytic capacitor can only go one way round on there. It's got a plus sign on it and a shaded sign to tell you which way around that's going to go. So that should be okay. And then power supply goes on there. So people keep telling me to do the smallest item first, which is that diode. Got a line on one end, silver end, there's a line on the circuit board. It's going to go in there. There's my soldering iron. Did I remember to turn it on? Yeah, that's okay. So, first item in place. Resistor. This guy is going to have to go through there and fold over. I'm probably being over cautious. Excuse me leaning in front of the camera. There wasn't any grease to go under there. Right, how are we doing? least I got that the right way round this time. I did one of these soldering videos and put that in backwards. A while ago that was. Right, this one. Because they've only pre-tinned the very ends of these. To open that hole a little bit. Work. This fella. It's gonna fit there. Keep a plastic strap around it. Right, we need a 3 to 5 volt supply, 3 amps it says. Okay, well, I'll find something I can plug into it and see what happens. Well, I'm not quite sure what we're expecting to ignite with this. I suppose it might ignite a gas flame or something. I'll just zoom in a bit so you can see how tiny the spark is I'm generating. I'm just using 4 AA batteries, so we got somewhere between 5 and 6 volts. Right. This is where we want to look. We want to see if we get a spark. Press the button. Is that even visible? I've got a single cell lithium ion battery now. So, that's better. What happens if we put a bit of paper through there? Oh yeah, that works. So yeah, it does work, just need to give it the right sort of current supply. So, yeah, success! And that's running it off. Oop, wrong way. That's a single lithium ion battery. That's come out one of those cheap power banks from Poundland. Be setting off our fire alarm in a minute. Yeah, success. So it works. There you go. Another cheap eBay electronics kit. Got that gap at about 1/4 inch now. Yeah, that works.
Hey, thanks for watching. There's plenty of videos on my main channel with more added daily, so don't forget to subscribe and enable the notifications to keep you up to date with my new releases. You can help keep my channel running by donating $1 on Patreon to buy me coffee. You can always find more information in the video description. Thanks again for watching.